All right, we're working on butterfly sweeps and variations. We are back into the original position. Right now I have everything going for me. And I'm only gonna do a variation if it's using something to prevent me from doing my classic sweep, right? You can use that arm to pose, which is what I bought. You can pummel that arm, which is the variations for that as well. He can wizard, like again, like I mean, figure out a way to neutralize that underhook, right? If I don't let anything happen, I have that on track, I have that underhook deep, he's not moving back, I have it all. He can still use that leg and post it, that prevent me from sweeping, right? So if you post that leg before I get started, I suppose that leg all the way out, it kind of like makes it hard for me to do that sweep, right? And the good thing for this variation is that he has to step all the way forward, right? He cannot just step all the way far away from me, because that's not going to serve the purpose of preventing this sweep, which is basically dropping him on his shoulder. So for him to defend my move, he's going to have to put that foot exactly where I want to drop him at, right? And as it does so, it makes it fairly easy for me to trap that foot, right? So the variation will go like this. That arm that was previously controlling the arm, you're gonna abandon it, you're gonna have that arm right under his leg, and you're gonna drop right on it as well. Kind of important detail here, like that foot that was pretty close to my groin doing nothing, right? In order for you to drop quick, you're gonna kick that leg all the way through from under the other leg, right? So you're gonna go like this, boom, all the way down, right? And as you dive, you use your hook to lift him over you and bringing him right on the other hook. What you're gonna have is the actual axe guard, right? Which was the reason why the axe guard was invented. There's a variation of the butterfly guard, you know, easy. All right, so here I am, axe guard, how am I taking down? Again, there are many things that you can do here, but the classic way is to start spreading his legs apart, keeping his foot trapped to a point that there's not a lot of weight on your upper body anymore. And post your elbow on the ground, do a technical lift, and then drop on the ground, and then just drag on him, right? That final phase of the technique is a bit of a scramble. It all depends on how much he's gonna resist, but as long as you have that foot trapped and then keep driving forward, eventually he's going down, all right? That's right here again. Classic position, he posts that leg, down I go. Boom, I swim right in, bring him over me, have that hook trap, make an X with my legs. Super important to get that foot trapped. If he takes his foot out of here, my technique is over. Right now, all I'm going to take him down. Spread his legs apart as much as you can. Post your elbow, post your hand, bring that leg back on your knees. Now just drive on him any way you can until he's down.